So guys, how are we going to negative an ASIN in an auto match? Well, this is a very, very challenging technique, but it's possible. You just got to know how to do it. So let's look into our campaign. So before we do that, let's look at one of our sponsor reports. We know that these ASINs are spending money. We're having zero results. Now, this campaign is not related with the product that we're looking for, but I'm just going to show you how to negative ASIN in an automatic campaign. So if you do this, and this is what's being taught out there, if that's what you're doing, then the result of this is, see, what's being taught in the market is to negative exact the ASINs and then hit keywords. Now, let me tell you what this one just did. The algorithm cannot read this. The algorithm doesn't know what that is. It's a mixture of letters and numbers. It has no clue what it stands for. It has no clue what it is. I mean, the keywords that the algorithm is used to is the actual keyword of a product. This has no idea. So let's take for example, and I'm going to show you a technique on how to negative an ASIN from your listing. So let's say okay, let's take one of the ASINs from here. So we are staying in the same format. Let's say we want to negative this ASIN. It is showing up for a product, but it's not converting. But it is the actual product that we're targeting. Let's take another ASIN. Let's take this ASIN. It's not relevant to our product, and we're showing up for that product page, but we are not converting. So we go into our campaigns, and instead of doing negative exact, instead of doing that, we're going to do negative phrase. We're going to go to Amazon. We're going to search for that particular ASIN, which we already have, right? Let's see, where is it? Where did it go? Okay, let's just put it in. Let's just put that ASIN that we highlighted. It was a pen. And so if we are showing up for this particular ASIN, when I mean if we're showing up means through the automation, automatic keyword targeting, your product might show up over here on the product pages through PPC manual campaign, or it might show over here. So let's say, and somebody goes and clicks it and doesn't buy it, and we didn't get any sales. So the way to do this is actually not to target the ASIN. We have to target the brand name. So this being the brand name, or you can always see the brand here, you can go there. Now, before you do that, you want to go inside the storefront. See which other products they're selling. If they're selling a similar product to you, then you gotta be careful on how you're gonna target. So they're not selling. So we take their brand name, we do negative phrase, and we tell the algorithm that, listen, anything with that brand name, negative phrasing. I don't wanna show my product for any of their products. And there you go. That's how you remove an ASIN from your automatic campaign. Okay. Now, if there was a product that particular seller was selling similar to yours, then you would have to note it down which products you don't want to show it for. Means you want to note down all the products that they were selling except for the one related with you, not to show up for. Just leave that one product to show up for, and that's it. You know, I mean, and if you're not converting for that product related to your product, then you just make it negative exact, the brand name and the product that you are. Why you want to do that is because if you're selling for $25 and they're selling for, let's say, $9.99 or $6.99, you definitely don't want to show up for that product. So just go and negative exact their brand name with their main keyword that is ranking for, and that's it. And not only just that one keyword, just all the keywords that they are ranking for to get in that position and get rid of it. Okay, so that's how you negative an ASIN from an auto campaign. We're going to move to the next lesson shortly. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.